Hey everybody, it's Carm here, and...
Hey,
johncoltrane68,
here with Cousin Carm.
Cousin Carm.
A little quick shout out to our dear brother and friend, Rob Paniks, and Massachusetts. It's not summer here, Rob.
No, not today, definitely not. We're definitely in the early throes of autumn. A little preview, what's to come. But, got together at long last, and hit a few shops in the area. One a little further away, but started out this morning, did some breakfast, and hung out for a bit, and then just went out. I started off at a place called Permanent Records, which is the only one of the four that we went to that wasn't in the immediate area. And here's what we found.
You want to go first? You go.
Okay. Yeah, I got quite a stack to say the least, and I have to say right at the outset, the majority of which were handoffs from this man here. And it all looked, I was trying to narrow it down as to what not to get, but I wanted everything, and he kind of helped me towards the end with the prices and everything, but very neat. So, okay, starting in here, Aurora Borealis with Mitch DeMadoff. I know it's something he'd shown in the past.
Yeah, it's really excellent private early 80s version. Much more dynamic than it looks.
And 1982. So, very nice. Bagelow Fun. $1 record.
It's good for a dollar.
Yeah, local. Yeah, in Chicago. Be very interesting, nice big band. See the percussion set up there at the top, very intriguing. These ones you wouldn't let me leave without.
Yeah, shout out to Fred, Big Star 1000.
Yeah, Fred, Australia, yeah. Urban Sax, I guess, all saxophones. Yeah, tenors, altos, baritones, yeah, the whole.
It's very drone based.
Yeah, very. Yeah, I haven't heard it yet, so it'll be.
you'll like it, trust me.
Yeah, he just told me it was just.
That's the
perfect
second one, actually.
That's
the first one.
First one here. Okay. And this artwork is quite something else. Wouldn't have known what to make of it, but I had just seen it. But I'm very forward to it. Here's one I picked. Found for myself. One of the few from my own picks. Sophisticated Lady by Fran Jarry. Not quite sure what it is. It appears to be an organ player. Maybe kind of a lounge type record.
It looks very,
yeah, like
some of those have surprises on them.
I see it's like covers, like there's Scott Joplin, and it's an original, so yeah, it'll be interesting.
It's probably big in some local supper club that time.
yeah, it does have that look to it.
That's just a great record.
Yeah, Transit Express, Opus Progressive. When you were showing it to me and the instrumentation on here, you got synthesizer, electric piano, it just looks like very dynamic.
The violinist, David Rose, did a great record on Inner City.
Okay.
It's kind of a de facto fourth Transit Express record.
I didn't even notice it before, but the violin on there, that's really neat. Yeah, I love those.
It's a very excellent French jazz.
Oh, very nice. Oh, great. Another one I picked on my own, Abyss, Dare to Dream. It's a female trio. Looks like a folk trio. What drew me to it was there's synthesizers on here, so it'd be like a mixture of different acoustic and electronic, so... from 1983, so it's pretty neat. And next up, Listening to Evening, Aludin Mathieu, solo piano, another Chris Handoff. I have one other by him on Windham Hill. Yeah, real contemplative. This was Chris very enthusiastically recommending this. Leroy Jenkins, Jazz Composers Orchestra for Players Only, recorded live in 1975. You can see some of the names on there. Yeah, it'd be
part of the JCOA series. I forgot which one. It's a great
one. I'll get who's who of the genre, definitely. A few more from this store. Iliad, Sapphire House. I love this cover. The piano. And are you saying it's like a progressive fusion type thing?
Yeah,
like
it's kind of a hybrid of, you know, there's classical influences, fusion. They have two records. It was like Sandy Allen's first band. Yeah, it's the second one. But they're nice. They're underrated, I think.
Okay. Yeah, keyboards, guitar, or keyboards, bass, and percussion. And the acoustic guitar. Some guests. So, yeah, it should be a real treat. And finally, Furs and Frohling, Ammerland. Beautiful cover. A trio of a guitar, keyboard, mellotron, or just a duo. A guitars, keyboard, mellotron. Yeah, very nice. I'm looking really forward to it.
Yeah, that's totally back.
Yeah, and, on the Brain label too, so yeah, I don't have a whole lot of Brain label stuff. And I think, real quick, CD, early Soft Machine. So that should be a lot of fun.
I got a couple. Just four. First one is a French band. I think it's their first record. Abus Dangereux with Abyss from 1982. They kind of sound like Pierre Morlinier and Gong. Maybe a little bit of rock and opposition, slightly in here, but nice record. I've heard it, I don't have it.
Totally new to me, like so many other things.
Some Peter Michael Hamill, a lot of you guys know this guy.
Yeah.
This is Transition on Kuk-Kuk from 1983, double. Kind of, like Carm would say, contemplative, kind of meditative.
Yeah.
Very healthy music. As Derek would say.
Yeah, very much.
Nice. This was a great score, even though I have this, but I could not leave it there. Melodic Energy Commission, Stranger in Mystery, from 1979 on Energy Discs. It's like a Canadian band that made two albums in their 45. They had Del Detmer from Hawkwind. It's very kind of like psychedelic, folky, world influences, electronic, amazing record. I've never seen one outside of online, so I just couldn't resist.
Very cool. Striking cover.
You'll have to listen to that.
Yeah, sample it later on, definitely.
And this was a nice find. Johnny Diani, Born Under the Heat, on Dragon Records, label out of Sweden. Who else is here? Nobody I really know off the top of my head, but I buy almost anything by Johnny Diani that I don't have. A fantastic late bass player out of South Africa. That was it for my finds for Permanent.
Permanent Records.
Yeah, my first time going there, so it's kind of cool.
Yeah, I've been meaning to wanting to get in there for the longest time, but it's such a, it's very much our type of thing.
Yeah, it's a good store. It's priced like you would expect.
Rarities and stuff.
Yeah.
And afterwards we came back into town and I went to Valhalla. A long time.
That's a long time.
Oh yeah, it's the next one.
Yeah.
Here's the. So yeah, starting with these. I think it's all in. Yeah. I like the other one. A lot of Chris Handoff's. This is actually the last thing, Diva, soundtrack album. It was totally unfamiliar. Looks like a nice mixture of artists and styles on there. That should be fun. I like soundtracks. I don't have enough of them though, and I've rarely seen the films that, you know, that accompany them. Another one, The Master and the Musician, Phil Keaggy. Something I probably would have taken a quick look at and passed up, but then Chris is like, oh no, This is for you. Yeah, guitar synthesizer.
Yeah,
it's like kind of reminiscent of Steve Tibbs.
A little bit, it's not a, even though he's a Christian artist per se, that's not a Christian, it's more progressive record than anything.
Yeah, so yeah. that should be really
on a Christian label.
yeah,
it's nice.
But just anytime hearing like an acoustic and electronic combination is always intriguing. This one, I handed off quickly, and I was very happy. Automatic Man. I know he's shown it. I've seen it a few times shown, but had meaning to find it, and I just never saw it before. But it should be terrific. Yeah, from Island.
Yeah, kind of died to death when it was released because it's a little too, like, because it's like a, I told you, it's like a mix of, imagine like a cross between like Prague, Spacey Fusion, Hendrix. It has all these elements in it. It's really, and by Eddie's really soulful vocals. It's
yeah, really could confuse hard. People maybe if they're not sure where to slide it, but yeah, very cool. See, Touchwood, Jukka Tolonen, acoustic guitar, really. Yeah, another handoff.
It's a Finnish guitar duo over here.
It's not familiar. From 1985, so yeah, very nice. Love the cover too, pastoral. One I found on my own, Aaron Copland. Music for the theater, music for movies. I know Gary, little Gary, brother out in New Jersey, Cosmic Pickle. He showed the Copland portrait, which is electronic interpretations of his music, but I didn't have any Copland, regular stuff, so I'm looking very forward to it. And I'd passed this up at first, and Chris pointed out Ernie Watts. I have some of his later stuff, but this is an early one.
I think it's like 69-ish.
Yeah, late 60s.
No, it's a good record.
So. Yeah, we'll see. I'm sure I'll enjoy it. I like his playing in general. A little nostalgic find here. Yanni. Nikki Nana from 1989. Kind of the roots of the instrumental stuff that I've gotten into over the years, so yeah, I couldn't resist this for a few bucks. Another Chris recommendation. Made to Measure, Volume 13. What was the genre you said it was? Like.
Particular volume, I think, is kind of a little bit like rock and opposition sort of stuff, modern classical.
Okay.
A little bit of fusion elements, but not much. But Derek is a big fan of this Made to Measure series.
Okay.
And I think Daniel Schnell is Belgian.
Okay.
It's just an interesting one.
Yeah, it's new to me, but it should be really, really interesting. I really like the artwork. Kind of raw quality to it. And finally,
I've never seen it
at their shop. Kay Gardner Fisher's daughter.
That's definitely different.
Yeah, I guess a different side to her, normal like ethereal, meditative. Is it what do you say, like sea shanties, like traditional?
Yeah, it looks like troubadour songs, like
okay.
sea songs.
Yeah,
dulcimer. No, who would probably like that? Ben Costello.
Yeah, sounds like Ben. Hey, Ben. Out in Costello Towers. Yeah, this does sound along these lines. Yeah, so this would be interesting hearing.
I'm curious to hear your thoughts on that one. I've never seen a copy of that around in field.
Yeah, I'd never even heard about it. And
yeah.
I'd only
so
heard
I think
her.
It's her last official line. 86.
86, okay.
And
yeah.
Even Keel.
Yeah.
A small little in his music.
Yeah, so yeah, it'd be intriguing. Very neat. Okay, then.
I got a couple things here. This is the first album by a really great musician. Her name's Debbie Fire. And this is her album, In Your Hands, from 1982 and on Freedom's Music. A really great women's music jazz record that often gets lumped in with folk, and it's not folk at all. She's a really lovely voice, kind of almost like Joni Mitchell when she sings a little bit. And, very percussive, kind of funky Latin. Bass jazz, really nice album.
Also, like a Michael Hurley cover, I'm thinking of the folk musician.
This is an interesting record. It pops up because it was recorded around here. It pops up all the time, and it's kind of interesting. It's a Truths of Truths contemporary rock opera. It's like a kind of like a pseudo, I guess, Jesus Christ Superstar thing. Kind of a little Axelrod-ish. It has some funky tracks, a break or two on it. It's just something when I see it cheap, I always grab it. It's an interesting kind of concept record.
Yeah, that looks different.
Speaking of Kay Gardner.
Yeah, there you go.
Can never pass any cheap Kay Gardner records. Moods and Rituals, Meditations for Solo Flutes. Just an absolutely beautiful lady and musician who sadly passed away years ago from cancer.
Yeah.
And like I told Carm, I got to see her play, and I met her actually. It was an amazing experience. Both kind of a touchstone artist for me or Carm. Just absolutely transcendent stuff in my opinion.
Yeah, anything by her, I'm always great energy.
This is cool.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Little David Allen.
Oh yeah.
Rest in peace.
Yeah.
David Allen, Now Is the Happiest Time of Your Life on Infinity. It's a solo Allen one. Of course, with members, I think, are gone. With, like, Carm pointed out...
I think it's I Am.
Yeah.
The longest cut.
One amazing, like, cosmic track.
Yeah.
You know, typically cosmically quirky, iconic classic Dave Allen.
Yeah.
God rest his soul. So,
yeah.
Really cool to have that. This one is just, like, a local, private, like, funky, boogie, modern soul thing. That I know that I have friends who would want this. Galeb Galab, Morning Sunrise, 1980. From 1980. It's like on his own label. I think it's, Minaj Productions. It's actually autographed by him. A lot of copies pop up autographed by the guy.
Oh, cool.
Because he used to gig around here all the time. Kind of sounds like Bobby Lyle, if you're familiar with Bobby Lyle.
Okay, I know.
Roy Ayers, Bobby Lyle. That's it.
Okay. And then we went on to Oak Park Records, which at one time was called Second Hand Tunes.
That was probably the weakest of the four.
Yeah, as far as, you know, finds. But there was actually one thing.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I picked up one that I left behind last time for some reason. But Steve Kuhn Trio, Childhood Is Forever. Steve Swallow on bass. And yeah, I love Elder Romano on drums.
Another good sign.
Yeah. On 1969, so, yeah, I always loved Kuhn's music.
French B.Y.G.
Yeah, French B.Y.G. Jazz Masters series, so.
I'm sure that's pretty good.
Yeah, oh, very nice. And I think just a couple CDs from there. Reich remixed.
That's interesting.
Yeah, Steve Reich, I guess, just like stuff throughout his career, just DJs took it and kind of... put their own take on it, so that'll be neat. And Hardball by Art Landy, piano solos. Never heard him play solo piano, I don't believe, just in other contexts, so that'll be neat. And Francesco Zappa. Actually, someone named Francesco Zappa, who Zappa, Frank Zappa, did synclavier, I guess, interpretations of the music, so that'll be fun, 1984. Yeah, that did it for that shop.
Yeah, I only got two at that shop. First one is Zaba Linder and the Rhythm Stick, Extraordinaire and Sky from 82. Zaba Linder was a drummer and pretty much founder of the Release Music Orchestra, really great German progressive jazz band. He had a band with the vocalist and keyboard player on here called ES. It's kind of like funky fusion rock, and that's possibly what this might be. I don't know what it was, but it was on Sky, and it was cheap. It was $3. So
just finding out that label
was a shot. I picked this up from my friend Mark Maxwell, who's not in the vinyl, the video version of BC, but this is a classic. Renee McLean Sextet, Watch Out from 1976. Is the Inner City pressing of Steeplechase record originally. Really great kind of Afrocentric spiritual jazz stuff. So I picked that up from my friend Max. So that's all I got there.
Very cool. And hit one more place, the Old School Records, which just outside of town, or it's in Forest Park. So just another place I've been going to for a long time. And just picked up a couple of vinyl from there. Right away, Chris enthusiastically showed this to me. And said, you gotta have it, if you don't. Ongoing. Terry Plumeri. You can see a couple of names there. Again, thinking of Gary, Ralph Towner, John Abercrombie. Yeah. 1978. So, are you saying it's kind of organ-like?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, it's pastoral, kind of melodic.
Yeah, so, yeah. Looking very forward to it. So, yeah, it was an easy
very
choice.
Very Cousin Carmish.
Cousin Carmish. Very, Cousin Gorbo. And, the other vinyl I got was just a compilation from Private Music, Piano 2. Got Yanni again. You got Suzanne Chiani. Joachim Kuhn. And Michael Reisman, who played with Philip Glass. So just, solo keyboard works from the late 80s, 87. So that'd be nice. And a couple CDs. Let's
see.
I think I left the other one in the car. It was a Doa CD. Ornette Coleman in Prime Time, Tone Dialing. I don't have any later Coleman. I think this is from the 80s or the 90s maybe, or it says 95, so that should be fun. And that's what I got from show a couple cassettes I actually got from the previous store. Andy Summers, World Gone Strange, looks like a promotional thing with no cover or anything. Private Music, Interludes, Soothing Sounds of Nature and Music. For a buck, I always like these.
That's Natural Symphony.
I love that. It was a Babbling Brook. So there you go. Babbling Brook in the garden here. And Aldo Ciccolini. Yeah, plays the music of Debussy. So, yeah, look, beautiful stuff. But, I think that's about it for all those, for my particular stack.
I got a couple here. I couldn't resist this for cheap. I have it, but I give it to somebody. Leon Thomas, Golden Sunrise on Magic Mountain, on Mega. Nicely on Thomas record. Couldn't let it sit there for the price. Leon Thomas. This is kind of cool. Ray Mantilla's Space Station Synergy with Steven Grossman. This is on the Italian jazz label Red from 1986. Great label. I have a few things on Red. Ray Mantilla is another one of those great Latin percussionists along the lines of Ray Barreto and Mongo Santa Maria. I've not heard this one, but it does have Eddie Martinez, who played with Palmieri. Steve Barrios is on here, another great Latin percussionist. So looking forward to that.
Nice energy in there.
This was cool.
That's really nice.
Music from Mato Grosso, Brazil, on Ethnic Folkways from 1954. Pretty nice shape. Kind of traditional Brazilian music from the 50s. Field recordings.
This was really nice, too.
And that's cool. Peacock. Sky Skating from 1982 on Ironic Records. It's like a small UK label. Really great find, in my opinion. One of her more obscure efforts. It's just her on electronics and percussion and voice.
Totally unfamiliar myself. I have a few myself, but that one's totally.
I was surprised to find that.
Very, very neat.
And then an interesting looking, I know this artist from somewhere, but I an interesting looking Private Press Fusion record. Keith Hutchinson, Alpha Omega, on label called Refuge from 1983. He plays Fender Rhodes, Oberheim, and he plays flute. Looks like two long tracks recorded in Johannesburg. During the height of apartheid in 1983.
Yeah.
So this should be interesting. It was cheap. So that was kind of cool.
Maybe it'll come back to you. Maybe if you hear it, it'll bring back some.
Yeah, I know. I'm just spacing on where this guy's from. But yeah, that's it for my finds and his finds.
Yeah. And afterwards, we just drove around a little bit. We did lunch, and then now we're here saying hello to you all and showing these.
We did in the garden.
In the garden, yeah.
The overgrowth garden.
The overgrowth garden, yeah. People want to see like a panoramic view of the yard, and it's just, they need so much work. You know, I show this clematis is finally blooming, and it's very fragrant, very beautiful, but pretty soon it's going to die off, and got to cut it all down and start from scratch. So, here it is, and here we are, and it's been great, getting together after such a long time, and my first duo video. I was thinking it's kind of came full circle because I first saw Chris, learned of him from seeing him on Derek's video when he was when Derek was visiting Chicago and they were together. So it's a great thing.
We just talked about the great energy in the vinyl community, all the great people.
Yeah.
Too many great people to shout out.
Yeah.
We'd be here till the garden grew even higher.
And you wouldn't see us anymore. We would just be engulfed,
But we certain things, like people we mentioned, we see certain records and think of certain people. We saw Plexi.
Yeah.
Hey, it's Ben, he's here.
Yeah.
French records galore. Yeah. Mostly crap. So don't worry, Fred and Christoph. We watch this the usual stuff that you guys make fun of in your videos. It's just been really nice. We both, I think, feel that this video, especially, we'd like to dedicate this video to Rob Paniks in Los Angeles. Just the amazing spirit that Rob has that kind of like epitomizes the best of the vinyl community, the best of the humanity,
absolutely,
for that matter. We both talked and knew that we should probably make this not even for our own amusement, but just for, because we knew Rob would really want to see this. So
yeah.
We love you, Rob. And,
absolutely. Seeing us together and...
Cousin Carm. Cousin Chris, if you want to call
Italian. Yeah.
Yeah, my grandma's from Sicily. So.
We all got that, it all comes around one way or another, absolutely. And, it's been a beautiful time, and and again, there's been so many people meeting up recently, and it's just great, just keep it going. The more the better.
This is our humble contribution to the meetup videos.
Yeah,
this is my second, his first.
Yeah, first ever.
Yeah.
First having someone else besides one of the felines. So first human guy,
And just handing him, making him spend money.
Yeah, absolutely. It was great. But everything, I was trying to figure out what do I, But I'm sure it'll all be worth it. I could almost hear the music now. I mean, really, it's that, felt off each other. So, until next time, hope we're all well. And, hope to do this again sometime. And, just keep spreading around, and we'll hopefully meet more of you in person as we go, just keep getting more people together.
I guess as Gary Bart says at the end of the album Unknown Rivers, he has a track called Peace and Love, and that's all we have for you. So,
absolutely.
As Gary would say, peace and love.
Yeah. And peace, love, and joy. Until next time.